another video for you guys. I'm here picking up AT&T International, going to the Peterson Trucks in San Martin. I guess this one has a pretty bad air leak, so I'm gonna go ahead and cage the brakes on this one. Let's get this done. I'm gonna leave it running meanwhile I cage the brakes. Thank you. occasion bolts. This one's not that good anymore. Most likely the drive shaft is a half, so I'll get this one. I guess this is different. I already have some bolts in there. Yeah, I guess it's a pretty big leak, I can hear it. We'll tie the steering wheel while I'm here. It's nice when they got air. Hey, it's nice that it has these. Normally those are on the electric brake on the older Fords. Oh, it's in the parking lot? Okay, let me get a hold of my brother, see where he's at with the flatbed, and I'll get right back to you with an ETA, or you want me to call the customer? I think I got it. It's, you gave it to me earlier. Okay. Let me confirm real quick. Yeah, that's correct. The guy's name is Quinn. Okay, sounds good. Alright, thank you. Alright. And normally the pictures off here all the way out. Screw this thing up. Make it so much easier when you're not tugging or fighting against that. Got to rip the seal. Right off. Nice and easy. are already caged.
Yeah, you can hear that.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like right under the tire, bro.
Yeah, I know. Thank you. I forget sometimes.
Shit, same with me, man.
Yeah.
That same impact, I fucking left it on top of the truck a couple times and drove off.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I had that thing happen to my wireless remote for the tow truck.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, and I ran that thing over. It cost me about $1,200 to replace.
Jeez.
Yeah, I know, and I was mad. Because that remote really makes a difference when you're hooking up semis and all that.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Let me just put these here for now, that way they don't drag on the ground.
Yeah.
Looks like this one's good. Yeah. You heading out right now?
Yeah, I'm gonna take this one back.
Oh, okay.
No rush, man.
Yeah, I'm almost done, man. Gotta hook up my lights, readjust the front, and I'm good to go. All right, guys, we're good. Have a good one. Yeah, these trucks are deceiving. They're heavier than what they look. guys, while I'm on the highway, I'll see you guys at the drop-off. Okay, guys, right here, pulling up to the dealership. I'm gonna go ahead and drop this thing in the back. This right here is their towing area, so yeah, drop it over here on the dirt side. Good thing I don't have to get under there to get my strap from the axle, from the drive shaft. And right here next to this bus is perfect. I'm gonna remove the rear tent or get a lighter tent, because at night, man, it's really hard to see through this. Shit, fucking mirror. Oh man, the mirror on the bus is pretty far out. Cleared it. Alright, let me go take a look before we go back any further. We're still good. I'm gonna try to get it in between here. Yeah, so these are my backup lights. I lost the other ones, so these are all beat up. We have these for backup. This one I left it pretty far out because these bars right here get in the way when you're doing turns, and that way you don't risk hitting anything. I mean, it's good to leave them out a little more than what you have to, but yeah. Alright, so here's the story of how I lost my other lights. I was towing a similar one of these, but it was one of those old Chevy Kodiaks. So what had happened was, the reason for the tow was that it broke down, but it broke down with this same basket facing backwards. So this thing was hanging out the back of the truck, probably about to like right here. So I had enough clearance to tow it, but I put my lights, which were my other good ones, put them on the basket, in the rear of the basket, which was pretty much right there. So I didn't think of it, but in the road, I guess that thing was bouncing around all crazy, that I guess on a pretty hard bump, my lights fell out. So I have no clue where they fell. I didn't have the IM on or nothing on there. So yeah, I got to the drop-off location, went to go get my lights, figured it out. I'm like, shit, where's my lights? And I lost them. So yeah, that's the story and how I lost my lights. Ah, oh, man, if I could go back in time, I would put a piece of, what is it, rappelling rope? Or a little safety chain on there, one of those little things to hang portraits and what is it, plant pots on the ceilings and all that. Yeah, I think will come in handy. But yeah, I ordered some new ones. I guess I got the nice Tomate ones, but taking forever to ship. That's right, I caged brakes. Let me turn the truck on. Socket. That way you don't have to be there forever testing with a wrench. So three ports, extended socket. Makes miracles happen. What makes your life easy? No reason to turn the truck on, that thing's not even on there anymore. I mean, it's not gonna engage. Really no point of starting this thing up and waiting for the air to air up. Thank you. is on there right now. Picture. Alright. Turn off the emergencies, close the windows. I'm gonna leave the key in there for these guys. Get out of here. Okay guys, well that's it for this video. I'll see you guys on the next one. See ya.